Hey all, Pastor Peter here. I wanted to talk about fresh ideas and original ideas. And I know that a lot of us, especially those of us who are leaders, who are pastors, or who are teachers, often want to have fresh and original ideas for our teaching or for our preaching, or even for management, leadership management, and how to do things with our volunteers and with the students that we have, with our congregants, in a way that would inspire them to follow God and learn the material that we want to give them. Now, often when it comes to fresh ideas, we'll do one of two things. We'll brainstorm, which is great because brainstorming, it forces us to have to think outside of the box and come up with ideas where we're not that critical or judgmental about it, because we're just trying to come up with a list of different creative ideas related to a certain topic. You know, we'll draw, we'll write out the word and we'll draw a circle around it, and then we'll put a whole bunch of lines around that circle that relates to that idea or that topic with all of the ideas around it. Another thing that we'll do often is we'll go online or we'll read a book of an expert in that area that we want to have a fresh idea about. And we'll see what has been working with other people, with other companies, with other churches. And then we'll think, hey, that'll work with ours. And so maybe we'll do that. We'll just modify it in order to make it ours. And those are good ways of doing things. And I'm sure we'll easily come up with a lot of different ideas through that method. But the problem with those two methods is that it's not your idea. It's not original to you. And also oftentimes it's rushed. So for example, when you look at someone else's book or when you go online, you're looking at other people's ideas. And although they may work and it's been successful for them and it may be successful for you, it's not your idea, right? It's not my idea when I go somewhere and rip off that idea and apply it to my church ministry. The funny thing is, in youth ministry, in seminary, we often talked about how youth ministry is all about legitimately and being okay and allowing everyone to rip off of each other's ideas, which a lot of it is, right? The whole concept of the youth group and a lot of the things that we do in youth group and even in college group is basically ripping off of other people's ideas that has worked, and we just make it your own. But again, it's not your original idea. It's not really coming from you. And so when you implement those ideas, it's not done with as much gusto and as much passion because it's not yours, right? Also, when you brainstorm, it may be your idea, but the problem with brainstorming is that it's fast, it's rushed, and it's forced. You know, oftentimes when you brainstorm, you try to come up with something quick, and even though it may take just 15 to 30 minutes and you come up with a list of 10 different things to do, again, even if you take hours, do you really think that you can come up with a really good, fresh, and original idea within a couple of hours related to the topic that you want to come up with good ideas for in order to implement that? So what I found in my experience as a pastor is this, that when I don't want to come up with an idea to implement is actually when I come up with some of the most original and freshest ideas I've ever had. As long as it's done with proper rest and proper silence and time of basically being alone and relaxing without any stress. Now, you can see how that already is going to be very hard because of the fact that often we live very stressful, really busy and noisy lives. Like right now, living in Taipei, it's very busy and often very rushed with the full-time job that I have here as a teacher. But if you really want to get fresh, natural, original ideas that come from your own mind and heart, that's what you need to do. And the reason why I say that is because that's exactly what I had experienced when I took a sabbatical. I took a sabbatical for about 3 months, a couple of years ago. My church allowed me to have a sabbatical, and I was really thankful for that. And within just the first 2 weeks, I came up with these ideas without even trying to come up with them, meaning that I was just enjoying my time reading different books on the Crusades and on other church ministries that had nothing to do with my church. And I wasn't even trying to think of ideas to implement for the youth college ministry that I had at my church, the discipleship ministry that was going on at my church. But it just came up. It just came up because I had a passion for it. Although I wasn't thinking about it, everything that I was doing from time to time, all of a sudden, it just came up where I thought, hey, why don't I do this when I go back to doing church ministry? Now, I know that a lot of us, we may not have 3 months to spare, but get this, these ideas started coming up within just a few days after I was fully rested, meaning that after about a week and a half, after being fully rested and fully transitioned from, maybe not fully transitioned, but in a large part transitioned from the busy life that I had as a pastor to just relaxing and enjoying the sabbatical about 1.5 to 2 weeks in, I was able to just have a relaxed mind, and things just started popping into my mind about different ministry, novel ministry ideas that I did not have before. And so what I encourage you to do is to do just that. If you have the opportunity, get yourself into a relaxed state. Maybe the next time you have time off for vacation, and instead of, and you shouldn't be doing this anyways because you're on vacation, you shouldn't be thinking too much about your work anyways. If you actually do this, I guarantee you, you will actually start thinking about your work, because that's, and I assume that that's your passion, which is why you're in that full-time job, and you'll start having fresh ideas about that particular thing that you're doing. So some people, those of us who have gone through youth ministry with me, I started doing this thing called the BORP, the Box of Random Prizes. Now, a lot of people don't realize where I came up with that idea. It's not like I was thinking, you know, how can I come up with this idea where I'll have a box or a bag and it'll be like Santa Claus, where after someone answers a really hard question from the Bible, or after a group wins a certain icebreaker game or an activity, they get to choose from the box of random prizes, and it'll be just a fun time where they can choose and get a random prize. And literally what it was it was either a box or a bag, and on it, it said B-O-R-P, box of random prizes. And what it was just previous donations of things that people don't want, or old stuff from my house that I didn't want anymore, and I just throw it in there. Okay, it could be as simple as just really old keychains in the shape of Taiwan, that, and I had a whole bunch of them. I forgot why I had a whole bunch of those, but I think it was given to me, and I only need just one or two keychains. So the rest, I just threw it in the box of random prizes, and so that people can actually get it as prizes, to something more expensive like actual video games, old video games of PlayStation, 4 video games that I didn't want anymore. And so I just put it in there. Instead of trading it in or throwing it away, I put it in the box of random prizes, because there was a lot of people in my church that had PlayStations. And so it would be all random, and they would have to put their hand in and just feel around and grab it. And it was just a fun experience for all of these junior high school, middle school, high school, and college students to be able to pick a prize from the box of random prizes, because it was random, it was funny, and you never knew what you were gonna get, and everyone wanted to know what did they get from this box of random prizes. Sometimes it was serious stuff too, like sometimes there's like old Bibles that aren't used anymore, or old commentaries or like a duplicate commentary of a certain book of the Bible, like the Gospel of Mark or something. I already had a whole bunch of similar commentaries on it, and so I put one in there and they can actually grab it. So there was, it wasn't just funny stuff, but it was also serious stuff. It wasn't just inexpensive stuff. There was some expensive stuff in there. And that is what made it interesting, is that it truly was a box of random prizes. Now, that's not the point. Okay, the point is, how did I come up with that idea? That idea came up in the very way that I said how to come up with fresh and original ideas. It's not like I brainstormed that idea up, nor did I go online and look for an idea and all of a sudden, hey, there's this idea called Box of Random Prizes. Nor did I look at a youth worker or youth ministry magazine or a book that said that that would be a good idea to implement. No, it came up, that actually was a fresh, original idea that I had when I was just relaxed, I was working, I didn't feel stress, and all of a sudden, boom, that idea came up. It might have even been a God thing, and it came up. And I was thinking, you know what, it would be really great if we had a box or a bag and the prizes in there wouldn't be like a typical prize, like an award or something, but it would be just random stuff that's from people's homes or from my own house, and people can get it as a prize or an award after winning a game or after sharing something really deep as a way of positive reinforcement for hard work, good work, or just for fun to be able to draw from there. And I didn't know if it was going to work. And after doing it once, it was a hit. It was like, what is this? We have this thing called the Borp. What is the Borp? It looked really weird at first. I mean, literally, it was just a bag, and I just put B-O-R-P on it. And it's like, people are like, oh no, here's another weird Peter thing. And that's the thing. It literally was another weird Peter thing. It was my own. And so I was passionate about it, right? And then it came to a point where people looked forward to drawing from the box of random prizes, to the point now, even after I have resigned from that church and left that church, people still talk about the Borp, the box of random prizes, and how they wish that they still had a box of random prizes, okay? So this is what I mean. These fresh, original ideas do not come when you're trying to find them. They do not come when you're trying to look online for them, because that is not an original idea. That's an idea from someone else. It does not come even when you rush to brainstorm to try to get one. It comes when you're not even thinking about it, but because you are already by default passionate for whatever it is that you want a fresh idea for, as long as you're relaxed and as long as you're not stressed and you're not busy, it'll just come in. It'll just pop up into your mind, okay? And I'm willing to even go out on a limb and say maybe it's a God thing. Maybe God knows that you're looking for a fresh idea. And so in times where you are silent and you are rested, God gives that to you. And maybe God has been trying to give that to you. It's just that you haven't been listening because you've been so busy and you've been so stressed out. And it's only after you finally are in a restful mood where your head is clear that you get these really great, fresh, and original personal ideas. You know what was another one? And this is purely vanity, but when I put that Team Jesus Racing sticker on my Toyota Celica, I used to have a Toyota Celica. It looked really cool. Okay, it was a sporty car, right? I didn't lower it, but you didn't really have to lower it because it really looked really, really awesome. It's the last model that they had, the last generation, that body kit that they had, the last generation model. And I decided, you know what? Why don't I just put up in the front, just for fun and also to be a witness, Team Jesus Racing. No one else is doing that. I mean, maybe some of the other import Rice Rocket car people, they're putting like, you know, Honda Racing or something. But you know what? I think I'll just put Team Jesus Racing just for fun. And it became a hit. Everyone knew that that's Pastor Peter's car, right? People would be going, hey, I saw you, Pastor Peter. Where did you see me? Well, I saw your car because you're the only one that drives a silver Celica with in the front on top of the windshield with the stickers that say Team Jesus Racing. I saw you, right? And so people know where I am because they'll see my car in the parking lot or they'll see me drive by and then they'll text me or they'll email me. Or when I see them again at church on Friday or Sunday, they'll say, I saw you at the mall or I saw you at this place or that. Or we know you're here. We know you're at home because we see your Team Jesus Racing car on the curb. That's your car. That's not your neighbor's Celica. That's your Celica, right? Came to the point where I actually didn't want to have that sticker on there anymore because of the fact that people knew where I was all the time. But I remember times where people would actually go up to my car and take pictures of it just because it had Team Jesus Racing on there. Anyways, again, that idea didn't come out by me looking at other people and going, you know what, I want to just be like them and put, you know, Team Jesus Racing, because no one has that on there. It's unique, right? I didn't brainstorm that. Who would brainstorm that, right? I was just relaxed, I was hanging out, and then it popped in my mind, hey, here's a fun thing I can do. Let's just go to one of those stores at the mall where they sell posters and stickers for stores and cars, and then just get a sticker that for the windshield that's with the font of Team Jesus Racing. And so that's what I did, right? It was cheap, it was fun and original, and now everyone remembers the day when I drove a Toyota Celica with the Team Jesus Racing logo on it. Anyways, I hope this has helped you. I know this video has gone a little longer than I wanted, but if you're looking for fresh and original ideas that's yours and not someone else's, this is a great way of doing it. But it requires you to live more silent, unhurried, an unstressed life. And then these ideas will just come up from time to time. Okay? And even pray for them because it could be a God thing. Anyways, God bless you and take care. Bye-bye.